people have failed in equal access to political power. Second, imbalance in economics. Imbalance in economics. There is great poverty in the Philippines. Picture reports in the newspapers tell us of economic development. But better and better we get reports from foreign evaluators of our economy saying, very good. But that is the macro level. Beneath the level of rosy reports is the real reality of people. The gap between rich and poor have gone even higher. Why? According to the statistics, about 28% of more than 95 million Filipinos are below the poverty line, which means that an income of 16,000 pesos a year, that would be the poverty line. And 27-28% of people are below that. They cannot earn 16,000 pesos every year. And it is equivalent to about 46 pesos every day. A little more than $1 every day. Think about the people who are poor, below the poverty line. Not enough food, not enough money to send their children to school, not enough adequate shelter or clothing. People die below the poverty line. They die of simple sickness like diarrhea. They have no way to go to the from the mountains to the from the valley to the homeless shelter. There are no doctors and nurses in the barrios in the Kulaman area of Cotabato. The priest in Cotabato in the Kulaman area has to bring down his own team, people who are sick, especially the tribal Filipinos, indigenous peoples. Otherwise they die. This is poverty. When you think of poverty in the slum areas, I think of it as more harsh. Poverty in the slum areas seems to be more harsh than rural poverty. Because in rural poverty, farmers can always pack up okay and survive. Here, they have to look at garbage cans to find out if there is any food left over. That's poverty, but it's worse. The other day, after the mass, there was a mass in the morning actually. I am 76 years old. I tend to forget things. What happened yesterday? There was a mass. Other religious and priests were there in the cathedral. Yeah, in the cathedral. And the Pope went to eat a meal with boys and girls in a shelter. To lie something. To lie. He went there to eat with the boys and the girls. To meet the children whose parents either have abandoned them or cannot support them anymore. He enjoys them. He goes forth, and not going forth only, he goes down among the poor, like Jesus did. Like Jesus, going down among the poor. This is economic poverty. The imbalance in economics. The top, the richest 10%, the richest 10% of the people in the Philippines earn 20 times more than the poorest 10%. I was 8. I was once invited for breakfast at a hotel. And all we had was pancake coffee, scrambled egg. I was looking for tuna, but there was no tuna there. I love dried fish with a lot of salt. There's no tuna. And I looked at the bill paid for by credit card. And I said, my darling, there are only four of us. The payment for the bill is almost equivalent to the monthly pay of a catechist in Cotabato. Wow. If that does not give you a guilty conscience, maybe you need another conscience. Or maybe you need another brain. Did you hear about the brain bank? The brain bank is like this. You have a blood bank. If you need blood, fresh blood, and a lot of it, you go to the blood bank and ask for blood bank or body. That is a brain bank. If you need another brain, you go to the brain man. And this man needed a brain because he was forgetful already. And so he went, how much is the brain? That brain is 250,000 pesos. Well, you're thinking of brain, and that's a good one. Brain, the most complicated organ of the human person. Brain, 250,000. Wow, what are you? Can you know brain now? The brain of an engineer. Voila. About the brain? That's 300,000 pesos. That's expensive because it is the brain of a doctor, medical doctor. And that one, talagang mahal yan. Mahal na mahal. Why? Because the brain of Cardinal Quevedo. Public naman, because it was hardly used. You can change that around, huh? You can change that around. Brain of a sister, brain of a priest, brain of a bishop, brain of a lay person, and then I change that a little bit to mention myself. Well, why did I tell that story? Because I was losing my memory. I need a brain. Yeah, okay. We don't know how we can.